Tilt of the hat.
We're down here at Collier's and Moston Boxing Gym. We've got Lyndon King Arthur with us. And there's some good news for you, Lyndon, because you're going to be on a big bill on the 23rd of September. Hughie Fury, Josie Parker undercard.
Yeah.
How did that come about, man?
Yeah, it's not that.
Yes, my manager Steve Wood, he messaged Pat. Asked him what going it. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure.
You see that easiest one?
I had a slot come up, but I took it obviously. I'm fighting on it. I'm ready. So that's what we're gonna do, man.
I mean, it makes sense, doesn't it? If it's a local Manchester show, getting the young Manchester prospects on it.
Yeah, it does. And I believe I'm one of the best coming out of Manchester, so I should. What are you laughing at? What are you smirking for?
A lot of people are talking about you, Lyndon, and of course, you know, in the light heavyweight division, we're calling out for young prospects because the division's not always been the big division. It's becoming that way now, though.
Yeah, it's getting there. It's getting there. There's going to be some big fights in the future. There is. You know, there's a good fight in Bullioni and Karen Johnson on that, and the Joshua card. And, you know, there's other fighters in the light heavyweight division that are making a lot of noise that are coming up or that are nearly there. So it's fun. It's already high in the worlds anyway. But domestically, it's getting a lot better. I'm glad to be a part of it.
Yeah. And of course, it's on a heavyweight world title undercard. I mean, that must be, you know, exciting itself, and at the Manchester Arena.
Last time I boxed at the Manchester Arena was on the Quella bill. Quella versus Anaris.
Yes.
One.
Yeah.
That was an amazing. What's the word? That was an amazing experience.
Yeah.
But I didn't perform to my best. So in myself, I've got a little bit of a point to prove.
Mm.
You know, and I'm ready and I'm going to look to do that on the 23rd of September.
Yeah. I know you like fighting on the small halls as well. You know, I know you like that sort of atmosphere.
That's where I was born into the game. Like, after the Crawler Bill, I went on the small hall show, a lot of the small hall shows. So that's where I learnt my craft as a professional more. And I feel like I'm a little bit better now than I was when I first started. So as long as I keep progressing, that's all that matters.
I mean, there is the point though that at some point in the career, to get that more sort of visible presence, you need to go onto these big shows.
You need people to see you.
Yeah,
you need the exposure. That's what you're looking for. You need the exposure. So getting on a big show every now and then until you are signed to a good, like a bigger promoter, is always good for yourself and self exposure. So, you know, this is good. This is a good platform for me.
And obviously, you're developing a reputation as being, you know, getting people out there.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, would you want someone, you know, for an ex-opponent that can give you a few rounds and just help you work on some other aspects of the game, or is that not really a concern?
Yeah, I know. Like, they always say in boxing, you don't get paid for overtime, and the longer you're in the ring, the more dangerous it is. Boxing is a dangerous sport. You always want someone to give you the round. You always want someone to give you the round so you can get more experience. But as long as you're sparring well, which I am, and you're getting the rounds in sparring, and you know, Anthony Joshua only just went 10 rounds, and he's knocked everyone out. I'm not saying I'm Anthony Joshua, but I mean, he's still a world champion, with 3 world title belts. So, you know, as long as you're getting the good sparring and you're training hard and you're leaving no stone in the gym, then it matters, but it doesn't, you know, as long as you're training hard, you'll be okay.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah. And a bit of a difference for the platform as well. The platform itself is going to be on a YouTube platform. And I know it was a bit of a surprise to a lot of people when it first was announced, but this could be the start of something which becomes the thing.
It could, you know. It's another channel for boxing to go on. Watch it, it's something different. We've not seen it before. It might take off, it might not, but you know, everyone has YouTube. Everyone can access YouTube. We have a phone, iPad, computer, laptop, TV. So, you know, it could be a new thing.
And I know you're obviously proud of the city of Manchester. It's one of the big shows. Obviously, they have the concert back at the MEM, but I know it's one of the big sporting shows.
It probably is the first
Yeah.
sporting boxing show that's going to be on, so it's exciting to be a part of that. Mm. Like opening for the sport of boxing on there, so yeah, I'm happy as well for that.
You seem very focused. I mean, I know as it comes closer to a fight, you're getting down in weight and everything. Yeah. But you know you do seem very focused for this particular one.
Yeah, nah, my weight's fine. I just want to perform. You know, that's what I just want to keep the momentum of my KO rate up. My 8th fight, I want my 7th knockout. That's what I have fun in boxing. So I guess it's a short career, so. But I want to be a big impact on the sport.
Mm.
So I'm focused, I'm ready.
Is that the sort of, the long-term goal? I know all fighters never look over fights and things, but I know all fighters also have a plan, a long-term goal.
Yeah, world champion.
Is that the goal, world title belt, yeah? Yeah.
A lot of fighters want to be a British champion, which is a great belt. I want to be a British champion, but that's only a stepping stone. I want to be a world champion. I will be a world champion. As long as I keep training hard and I stay focused and I stay on my job, I think eventually I will be able to contend up there. So that is where I will end up. That is where I want to be.
Mm-hmm. Well, we've not got long to wait for your next fight, September the 23rd. It's only around the corner, really.
Yeah, a week and a half now.
Yeah, a week and a half. And, you know, we're looking forward to next week, fight week. It's always an interesting week for you. Do you have any sort of rituals or little things you do in fight week to get yourself in the zone, superstitious in any way?
Yeah, I go for a walk on the day of the fight. I go for a walk after the weigh-in, listen to my music, I chill. I might watch a few fights. I always watch boxing anyway, but might watch a few fights of things that I might think will work in the fight, of boxers that do what I'm going to try and do. Nothing really, there's no superstition. You can't have superstition because the situation might not be the same the next time. I might not fight here next time. I might fight in London. I might fight somewhere else where I can't do the same thing that I do when I'm here. So I don't like to have superstition. I did in the amateurs.
Yeah.
I used to have the same boxes and socks.
Yeah, on every fight,
The lucky boxes and socks. I remember one time when they lost them, I didn't want to fight.
Yeah.
So after that, I'm not superstitious with them, but I'm certain things. But
have you still got them boxes and socks?
Nah, not used to. I'm not. I never used to wash our kits. Yeah, I never used to wash my kit either.
Yeah.
My amateur kit in a competition.
Yeah.
AVAs or whatever. We've going.
It's all coming out now, you see.
Yeah, it might have stunk in there. If I fought you and it smelt, I'm sorry. Zaf was the same. No, we never used to wash our kits when we was winning.
Yeah.
So that only stuff like that. But no major superstitions. Because like I said, situations can change. And,
yeah. Well, there's one situation that isn't changing, and that's that you're becoming more well known and more of a rising prospect in Manchester and on the UK.
I'm ranked 16th now.
Yeah.
I didn't know that till the other day. Yeah. I want to be ranked number 10 by the end of the year, or in the top 10, or near the top 10. How night works though?
Well, it's a lot of it depends on who you fight.
Yeah. It's points thing.
Points,
it?
Yeah.
But I'm coming. I say it all the time.
Yeah, man.
I'm coming, man.
Well, you heard it here. Lyndon King Arthur, he's coming for you. We'll catch up with you again next week in fight week, obviously. But thanks for your time, and we're looking forward to anyone just want to shout out just before we go?
Boxraw, Stanley Jacks, Wham Sandwich, Intense Menswear. Spectrum Rail. Collier's a must in ABC, Brian Hughes, Pat Barrett, Paulie Young Silver, Tommy McDonald, Matthew Ward. All type of man them.
All right, you just did it, man. Right, good luck, Lyndon. We'll see you soon, man. Aki Kareem, British Boxers. Power.
I hope you haven't forgotten.